I would like to get to know if it could be. Forgiving yourself is about more than just putting the past behind you and moving on. It is about accepting what has happened and showing compassion to yourself. Facing what you have done or what has happened is the first step toward self-forgiveness.
Hey babes, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Sincerely Ashley, and I'm back with another video. Dripping straight into part four of the Self-Love Affair series. We're going to be discussing self-forgiveness. Self-forgiveness is so important. I'm going to be giving you 5 tips on how to forgive yourself, okay, so you can move on and prosper in life and just be happy. So I really hope these 5 tips are beneficial to you, especially as we, you know, go down the self-love. A lot of us, you know, we may not be able to, or feel like we're not able to, or we don't really know how to forgive ourselves. No worries, I got you. Tip number 1, disconnect your mistake from your identity. What does that mean? Tip number 1, disconnect your mistakes from your identity. What does that mean? If you keep beating yourself up over and over again for doing something wrong, you're never going to feel better about the mistake or the situation. Knowing that your guilt served the purpose, you won't keep torturing, feeling like you have to torture yourself like for forever. Okay, so our brain has a vested interest in making sure that at all times that we remember that we're people that are capable of hurting someone else. So that we never do it again. This is why after we make mistakes, we feel so bad, we feel so overwhelmed, and we don't make the same mistakes over again. Our brains harp those things and create a warning signal for us. But if you can recognize that you haven't done it again, because you can begin to stop obsessing over whatever the mistake may have been. You have to decide and say, okay, this is the thing that happened. This is not who I am. Rather than carrying the fear around that you'll mess up again, turn it into wisdom. Like, okay, I did this. I learned from this. I'm not going to make that mistake again. Tip number 2, write down your thoughts. Okay, journaling is such a powerful tool in all kinds of psychological healing, but here it can be especially helpful. One of the things I suggest when someone is dealing with, you know, self-forgiveness is to write down their feelings and demand evidence from them. You know, ask yourself, am I really untrustworthy, or did I just do one untrustworthy thing? Explore the answer in your writing, listing the untrustworthy things that you actually did or that you may have done. You may find it to be a very short list of things. Tip number 3 is ask for forgiveness. So odds are, if you did something bad enough that you haven't forgiven yourself for, there was probably someone else involved. Part of forgiving yourself is letting the other person or other people know that you know that you were wrong. The only way to feel whole is to be able to feel vulnerable and speak up. So if you did something bad, step 1 is to say it out loud and take ownership. In other words, the other person or people may not forgive you. And that's totally okay. You're not standing up and forgiving them just because you want to be forgiven back. No, because 9 times out of 10, you've already had a narrative in your mind, in your head, that you were wrong, and letting them know that you felt that way. What they do next does not stop you from forgiving yourself. Someone can say, no, I'm not forgiving you. Whatever you did was wrong, and it made me feel like whatever. Okay, cool. So what? they're entitled to their feelings just like you are entitled to stop torturing yourself and forgiving yourself. Number four is accepting the consequences. So whatever the consequences may be able to own up to it. Like I said, own up to your mistakes and be able to accept whatever the consequences may be. Whether or not it's like you guys not being friends no more, or like your relationship ending. Whatever the consequences may be, we have to be able to stand up and take that and be able to move on with our life. Life doesn't stop. The world does not stop twirling. We have to be able to just accept the consequences for whatever it may be, whether it makes us feel good or not. And we have to be able to push forward. Tip number five, and this is the last tip, being patient. So basically, so often when we feel a sense of embarrassment or guilt about our actions, we want everything to be back to normal. Like, that's something we all like have been through. Like, dang, I wish, I just cannot wait till this is over with. I can't wait till things go back to normal. But we can't rush our own feelings, and you most certainly can't make anyone else move faster on their emotions. So instead of drowning ourselves in whatever happened, try accepting there's nothing else that we can do to make this situation any better, and just press pause on all the worrying. When we're able to push pause on all the worrying, you know, of course the feeling's still gonna be there tomorrow and the next day after that. But at least we won't have ruined our like entire day by carrying that over and just worrying and worrying and worrying. So just push pause for a minute, take a breather, let things go, let things flow, and just work themselves out. We just got to be patient and keep pushing forward with life, okay? So that was all five tips that I have for you babes today on forgiving yourself, self-forgiveness. I hope that you all enjoyed this video. And I hope that you all can, you know, really just take some time and go over the five tips that I've provided with you all, and just go back and be able to self-evaluate, you know, on whether or not you have really been able to sit and forgive yourself. That is a really important step in the whole self-love journey. It's very important to be able to forgive yourself, because if you don't forgive yourself, you're gonna have a very hard time. Stay tuned for episode 5, as we will be talking about how to let go of toxicity. So that means toxic things that you're doing, toxic people, whatever is toxic in your life. I'm gonna drop some gems on how you can let it go, okay? So until next time, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Share my video with a family member or friend. Until next time, babe, stay safe. I would like to get